The Pouch of Douglas, named after Scottish anatomist Dr. James Douglas from the 17th century, is a space, a region, a site, a location of the female pelvis. Specifically, an extension of the peritoneal cavity into the pelvis. Well, the peritoneum is the serous membrane that lines the abdominal cavity and contains the abdominal organs, at least the intraperitoneal ones. The vast majority of the small bowel, for example, is intraperitoneal, and therefore enveloped by the peritoneal membrane. The uterus, the bladder, and the lower two-thirds of the rectum, on the other side, are below the peritoneal membrane, and therefore can be classified as infraperitoneal or subperitoneal. They are below the peritoneum and therefore in the true pelvis. That's why we call them pelvic organs and not really abdominal organs. Well, technically the middle third of the rectum has a single fold of peritoneum in front of it, anterior to it, and therefore could be considered perhaps retroperitoneal rather than infraperitoneal. But in the end, what really matters is that if the peritoneum covers the uterus, the bladder, and part of the rectum, the regions between these organs will form small, mostly impermeable, pouches or sacs, extending downwards from the abdomen, where fluid can get pulled. The depression between the bladder and the uterus becomes known as vesico-uterine pouch, and the region between the uterus and the rectum becomes known as the rectouterine pouch, or pouch of Douglas. The reason this is anything more than an anatomical curiosity is because notes here that these areas continue connected to the abdominal cavity. By any means, they are intraperitoneal, inside the peritoneum, which makes them very caudal or low in the abdomen. The pouch of Douglas, in fact, is the most dependent portion of the abdominal cavity, the lowest hanging segment of the peritoneal cavity. And therefore, thanks to the action of our friend gravity, unless you happen to be an astronaut orbiting Earth, the place where all the fluid from the abdomen will tend to drain too, and then accumulate. This makes this small cavity, limited anteriorly by the uterus and the posterior fornix of the vagina, posteriorly by the rectum and inferiorly by the peritoneal rectovaginal fold, one of the prime sites to diagnose conditions such as ascites, abscesses, or hemoperitoneum, since all fluid would just be drained downwards into the pouch of Douglas, be it transudate, exudate, blood or pus. If you want to know if there's fluid in the abdomen, the pouch of Douglas is a very sensitive place to look at. Traditionally, this verification was made through Culdocentesis, basically inserting a needle into the vagina and perforating the posterior vaginal wall to reach the rectouterine pouch. And this procedure still exists, however, mostly in the absence of ultrasound. If you have access to a transvaginal ultrasound, it might be better to just look first for the presence of fluid through the ultrasound without the need for the needle. Unless, of course, you wish to collect the fluid from the pouch of Douglas in order to culture it or submit it to cytological studies. Thank you for watching this video. Please bear in mind that this video is meant only as a medical review and should not be used to guide medical decisions. For that, please seek your physician or the latest protocols. If you've liked this video, please consider checking my gynecology playlist, as well as those on other medical themes. Thank you for choosing to spend your time with me, and I hope to see you on the next video.